So, dear friends, we are meeting once again to continue with the second topic, that is modulation and demodulation. In the last period, we studied about the types of digital modulations, that is ASK, FSK, PCM, PWM, PPM and PAM. So all these are the types of digital modulations. And today we are going to deal with another aspect of the topic, and that is known as demodulation. Friends, we know that modulation is the technique. It may be analog modulation or it may be a digital modulation. They can be used at the transmitting end. Whereas the demodulation technique is used in the receiver or at the receiving end. In the last period only, just we have introduced the process of demodulation, where we have studied that demodulation is the process by means of in which we can recover the original information from the modulated wave to be processed in the receiver and can be provided to the destination. In short, the process of separating the original information, that is a modulating signal, from the modulated wave is known as the demodulation. So during this particular demodulation, maybe original information is going to be deviating from the point of view of frequency, from the point of view of amplitude, or even though from the point of view of phase. If so generated, separated, modulating signal has different amplitude components, it is called as amplitude distortion. If it possesses the harmonics of the frequencies, then it is called as a frequency deviation. If suppose it possesses any deviation in the phase, then it is called as the phase distortion. Maybe such a distortions are likely going to be appearing after the signal has been demodulated. So by removing that particular distortion, naturally the modulating signal is kept ready for the further processing. Thus, in short, the process of separating the original information from the modulated wave to be processed in the receiver is known as the demodulation. Friends, depends upon type of the modulation used in the transmitter, there are different types of the demodulating circuitries which are used in the receiver. These demodulating circuitries are known as the detector. Another name for demodulation is the detection. If suppose the signal is amplitude modulated, then AM modulators are used, AM demodulators are used. And if the signal is say FM modulated, then FM demodulators are used for the purpose of demodulation. Let us see the description of the same and to proceed further. The process of recovering the original modulating signal from modulated wave is known as demodulation or detection. Basically, it is a process of frequency translation
that requires non-linear device which converts high frequency signal into low frequency signal. In another way, we can say in the process of demodulation, high frequency signal will be converted into the low frequency. Any deviation from the wave shape of modulating signal is known as distortion. If the output of demodulator contains the frequency which are not present in the modulating signal, it is called as amplitude distortion. The high frequency deviation is a frequency distortion, and reduction in frequency component with the altered phase relation is known as the phase distortion. We are going to study AM detector as well as the FM detector. To continue with the AM detector, means these are the detectors used for the used for demodulating the amplitude modulated signal. These are of two types. One is a linear detector, second one is a non-linear detector. Linear detector means the device is going to be operated in the linear region for the purpose of detection. And non-linear detector means the device that is used for the demodulation works in the non-linear region of its characteristics. Furthermore, the linear detectors are again two types. One is non-coherent or envelope detector. Second one is coherent or synchronous detector. Friends, in your syllabus for detecting the amplitude modulated signal, envelope detector has been introduced. And now we are going to study details regarding the envelope detector. So, envelope detector makes use of a linear region of PN junction diode connected with the parallel combination of resistance R and that of capacitor C. Means to understand, this is the envelope detector. As we studied that, it makes use of the PN junction diode to which the parallel combination of resistance and capacitors are connected. This circuitry, we can call it as, it is the envelope detecting circuitry. We'll see details afterwards. As diode is operating in the linear region, it belongs to linear detector. As the diode is operating in the linear region, the output voltage is proportional to the input signal voltage during the positive op cycle. Depends upon how you are going to connect the diode. During negative half cycle, diode doesn't conduct, but output voltage is maintained by the capacitor that discharges during the negative cycle. The charging and discharging depends on the time constant RC. If time constant is correct, the output voltage will follow the envelope. So this is how the circuit works. If you look to envelope detector circuit, it is very simple circuit which is connected in the receiver for the purpose of demodulation. It makes use of diode D to which the parallel combination of R and C are connected. When diode receives the positive half cycle of the modulated wave at the input, it will conduct and allows current to pass through the load resistance R and also current to pass through the capacitor, so that capacitor will go on charging towards the maximum value known as V peak or Vm. But when a negative half cycle is reached to the PN junction diode, the diode will be reverse biased, it acts as open circuit and it doesn't conduct the current. This working of PN junction diode, we are well aware. Hence, in reverse bias condition, no current flows through the resistance R, and also in capacitor C. Hence, the capacitor doesn't charges. Practically, no voltage has to appear across the resistance R. But during this particular reverse bias condition of the diode, the capacitor which is charged in the forward bias condition of the diode, it will discharges across the resistance R, and it will maintain the voltage even in negative half cycle also. Thus, across the output, we will get the envelope of the input signal. This is the amplitude modulated wave which you already studied. If this wave appears to the PN junction diode as an input, if it appears to be a positive cycle, it will be forward biased. Capacitor charges and output will be made available. But during the negative half cycle, means during this particular aspect, naturally capacitor doesn't charges, no current flows through the R, but the charged capacitor discharges and it allows to follow the envelope at the output. These are the rectified waveform as it is. As these waveforms are obtained at the output, the aspect is that we have to get the modulating signal. No doubt we got the rectified output voltage. We have to remove now carrier wave. To remove those particular carrier wave, one has to adjust the time constant. If the time constant, that is R into C, is properly adjusted, then naturally the carrier wave will be removed, means the perfect filtering action that takes place, and only modulating signal will be made available at the output. So this is how the modulating signal is separated from the amplitude modulated wave, only with the fact that the time constant of R and C, that is RC product, should be properly adjusted. If you look to the figure, diode is going to act as a half-way rectifier and capacitor is going to act as a low-pass filter. Thus, high frequency will be converted into the low frequency signal, and that's what we can call it as, it is a frequency translation that takes place in amplitude detection process. Now we are going to see how the time constant R and C is going to be adjusted. The RC time constant plays the important role. If RC time constant is less, the output voltage falls off considerably during the non-conduction period of the diode and will not follow the envelope. The output is quite low with high ripple. If RC time constant is less than that of it is required, under that condition, output voltage will falls off considerably during the negative half cycle of the input, and it will not follow the envelope. No doubt, during the positive half cycle, it will conduct, but during the negative half cycle, when capacitor discharges, as a being RC time is less, it quickly discharges and doesn't follow the envelope. Hence, the output is less and it is containing high ripple. Now, if suppose RC time constant is more, when RC time constant is increased, which results marginal fall in the output and follow the envelope. So, if RC time constant is more, capacitor will take more time to discharge and allow output to produce the envelope. But if further increase in RC time constant makes the discharge rate of capacitor low and the discharge curve becomes horizontal. If the rate of fall of modulated envelope in negative half cycle of the modulated voltage output is faster than the rate of fall across RC time constant, the output fails to follow the modulated envelope and results a distortion. That distortion is known as diagonal clipping. this indicates that RC time could not, RC time constant should be more, no doubt about that, to follow the envelope, but it should not be too more so that the wave appearing at the output is going to clip, and again avoids to follow the envelope. In short, the RC time constant should be properly adjusted. It should not be much less, it should not be much more. Even though RC time constant is a proper, diagonal clipping is resulted due to increasing modulated frequency that makes the slope of modulated envelope steeper than the discharge curve of capacitor during the negative half cycle. What this indicates? This indicates that even though RC time constant is properly adjusted and if the modulating signal frequency is more, then also the diagonal clipping is going to result in the negative half cycle. Increase the depth of modulation also results a steeper slope of the modulated curve. Depth of modulation means modulation index. Modulation index also should be properly adjusted. Modulating signal should be, frequency should be properly adjusted. RC time constant should be properly adjusted. If all these factors are properly adjusted, then and then only at the output we will get the envelope that contains the modulating signal. Thus, the selection of proper RC time constant is made depending upon depth of modulation and the highest frequency transmitted. So, our interest is to calculate RC time constant which is necessary to produce the envelope at the output. The RC time constant is obtained as, we know R and C are the RC network. In general, if the voltage source is connected across the capacitor, then capacitor charges and voltage developed across that particular capacitor at any time t is given as voltage across RC combination VC at a time t, at an instant of t, which you have studied in BSc part 2, try to remember, in the time based circuitries. To decide the RC time constant, paper number 6. With that particular reference, the voltage across RC time constant VC is given as VC is equal to VO into e raised to minus t upon RC. This is the discharging equation of the capacitor during the negative half cycle. In general, we can say after capacity has been charged, the discharging equation is given as after discharging, voltage across capacitor becomes equal to VO into e raised to minus t upon RC. Differentiating equation 1, we can get differentiation of VC with respect to t, that is dVC by dt, equal to VO into RC into e raised to minus t upon RC. This minus sign we have written because differentiation of this quantity is minus. We have taken this minus sign to the left side. Actually, it is dVC by dt equal to minus VO into VO upon RC into e raised to minus t upon RC. This minus sign is taken to the left side, and that's why we can get an equation minus dVC upon dt, and that's equal to VO upon RC into e raised to minus t upon RC. But from equation number 1, VO into e raised to minus t upon RC is VC. Means this VO into e raised to minus tc, that's equal to VC. Therefore, we can get minus dVC by dt equal to VC upon RC, replacing VO into e raised to minus tc by VC from equation number 1. This is in general equation we have obtained. Now, for modulated wave, the decrease in voltage across C follows the modulated envelope. If single frequency sine wave voltage is used, then for modulated wave, now this is a general equation. Now we are dealing with our demodulation circuitry after applying the modulated wave to the input. Then voltage across capacitor is given as k into ec into bracket 1 minus ma sine of omega mt equation 3. This equation is available in amplitude modulated wave. Same equation we are considering. That is, vc is equal to k into ec into bracket 1 plus ma into sine of omega mt. Let me call as equation number 3, where k is efficiency of detecting diode. Ec is the amplitude of the modulated wave. Ma is the modulation index. Omega m is the angular velocity of the modulated wave. Now, differentiating equation 3 with respect to t, we can get dvc by dt equal to k into ec. Differentiation of 1, it is 0. Differentiation of ma sin omega t is given as ma into omega m into cos of omega m t. By giving minus sign to left side, minus dvc by dt equal to minus k into ec omega m ma into cos of omega m t, let me call as a equation number 4. In practice, this minus dvc by dt should be kept large. Means dvc by dt should be greater. Therefore, we can write minus dvc by dt is greater than or equal to minus k into ec omega m ma into cos omega t from equation number 4. But minus dvc by dt from equation number 2, it is vc upon rc. Put it here, vc upon rc is greater than or equal to minus kec omega m ma cos of omega m t. This we have written from the equation minus dvc upon dt equal to vc upon rc, that is from equation number 2. Thus, we can write it, vc is equal to, from equation number 3, vc is equal to kec into 1 plus ma into sine of omega mt. So, that we have written k into ec into 1 plus ma into sine of omega mt upon rc, which is greater than or equal to k into ec omega m ma cos of omega mt. This we have written from equation number 3. We have replaced vc by kec into 1 plus ma sine of omega mt here. Thus, we can write it 1 plus ma sine of omega mt equal to, means this equal to, this term we have taken to the right side, it becomes rc upon kec. 1 plus ma into sine of omega mt, we have taken this term to the left side, upon minus kec omega m ma cos mt is greater than or equal to rc. We have transferred rc to the left side and this term to the right side. By differentiating this, we can get sine of omega mt is equal to minus ma and cos of omega it is equal to square root of 1 minus ma square. Friends, here I have eliminated so many steps to reduce the derivation. We obtained the value of sine of omega mt as a minus ma and cos of omega mt as a root of 1 minus ma square. By putting these values here respectively, we can get RC time constant is greater than omega m into ma. Means to adjust the RC time constant properly, the condition is that the product of an R and C should be greater than or equal to omega m into ma. Ma is the depth of modulation or modulation index. Omega m is 2 pi fm. Fm is the highest modulating frequency. By knowing the modulation index and by knowing the modulating frequency, one can decide the value of R and C. So by connecting that value of R and C in this equation at the output, we can get the proper envelope of demodulated signal, and thus amplitude modulated signal will be that containing the carrier wave and also the modulating signal. From that, modulating signal is separated and it is used in the receiver for the further processing. This condition is true for low value of modulation index and for highest frequency up to 5 kHz to be broadcasting with the modulation index 30% to 40%. Means we have to adjust the modulation index 30% to 40% to validate this particular condition. Once this condition is satisfied at the output, definitely we will get the amplitude demodulated wave. Friends, this is how, by using the envelope detector, one can recover the original information from the modulated wave, and then it is analyzed further in the receiver to get the respected audio or video signal for the required purpose. So that's all about today's lecture. In the next time, we will study the FM demodulator, namely discriminator.